What have you done to Max?
Shut up.
You can't just...
Shut up! This is an interrogation. I ask, you answer. Name.
Laura Kearney.
Who are you traveling with? And what is your relationship?
Max Brinley, he's my boyfriend.
Where were you headed last night?
To Hackett's Quarry summer camp. You already know this. What have you done with Max?
No. I ask, you answer. That's how this works.
Fine. What do you want to know?
Oh. Well. Why were you going to Hackett's Quarry last night?
Max and I are camp counselors.
Oh, bullshit. Counselors aren't due until today.
I told you, we drove up and got there early. We figured we'd just go to camp.
Why didn't you go to the motel like I told you?
Because we were, like, way closer to the camp, and we're broke.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Sheriff. Hackett? Wait, Hackett? Like, Chris Hackett?
Don't change the subject.
What the fuck is going on here, man?
You have no idea what's going on here. Not a goddamn clue. You just stepped in some grade A double prime, go ahead and kill yourself cosmic type shit, young lady. And your only option is to buckle the fuck up and do what I say. Do you understand?
Stop trying to intimidate me and tell me what the fuck is going on. Is Max alive? I feel like I'm going crazy. What?
Let's go.
Hey. Hey, you! Asshole! You wanna tell us what the fuck's going on?
Max!
I know you hear me!
Max! Are you okay?
Yeah. I mean, I'm kind of all mixed up, but more or less intact, I think. Laura?
Yeah?
Why am I naked?
What?
I mean, after we got attacked, the next thing I know, I'm waking up in a jail cell, and you're gone, and now you're back again, and I'm super naked, and there's blood and stuff everywhere. I mean, what the fuck happened?
I was kind of hoping you could tell me what happened.
I feel like I remember bits and pieces, but none of it makes any sense.
Yeah, same. I feel like... Were we drugged? I feel like maybe we were drugged.
By a cop? Do they do that? Who does this guy think he is?
Well, Sheriff of North Kill, apparently.
North Kill?
Yeah. Max!
What?
Did you even look at the map? Hackett's Quarry in North Kill, that's the town.
Oh.
And it gets better. I gotta look at his name badge and...
Get dressed.
What's he giving you?
I'm not gonna be the guest of honor at Fashion Week, I'll tell you that much.
Hey! Did I say you could talk to each other?
Sorry, sir. We'll be quiet.
We will?
Max?
Hey, what'd you do with my real girlfriend?
All right, buddy. Hands through the bars. Come on. Your turn. Let's go.
I'm not going anywhere. We can talk right here.
Come on.
Hey! Hey!
What's up?
Get the fuck off!
Come on. Move.
Good boy.
Hey! Stop struggling!
Hey! Leave him alone!
Yeah, leave me alone, asshole.
Both of you, shut up!
Fuck you!
I said shut up!
Hey! Hey, you can't treat us like this! You're hurting him! Hey! Gotta be something in here you can use. Sis. Not a chance. I need some sort of lever. While the town of North Kill lay there sleeping, the hag in the woods started weeping. As the bodies decay, the wolves hunt their prey, and the sheriff continues his creeping. That could work. Do it. Yes.
Watch it, man. I bruise easily.
Give me a break.
Hey, the second we get out of here, you're toast, motherfucker.
Sure. Second you get out.
Wait. Well, answer your questions. You just can't lock us up in here with no goddamn explanation and expect us to be all butter and cupcakes, okay? Just work with us here.
You have nothing to bargain with.
Come on! Hey, you can't just leave us in here!
Hey! Come back! Fuck!
Son of a binky bonky. Are you okay?
It's just a foot. It'll heal.
I meant the interrogation.
Oh. Yeah. Can't break old Max. Many have tried, many have failed.
I'm being serious, Max.
He just asked a lot of questions. A lot of weirdly specific questions about us and where we were going and why and how I was feeling this morning and... I don't know. Nothing I said made him seem any less annoyed.
He asked how you were feeling?
Yeah. Why, he didn't ask you?
No.
Huh. Rude.
Oh, hey, did you get a look at his name badge?
You mean it's not really Detective Dick Whippet?
It's Hackett. Sheriff Hackett. You think he's related to Chris Hackett?
Oh my God, like the Chris Hackett?
Yeah.
Who's the Chris Hackett?
As in camp leader Mr. Hackett of Hackett's Quarry, remember?
Man. Last night feels like a lifetime ago. The fuck does that mean, though? You know? Were we set up?
Maybe it's some kind of crazy camp counselor kidnapping ring.
That's... I mean... What?
Well, I guess Sheriff Hackett's not exactly acting like a typical kidnapper, but... He's not acting like a typical cop, either.
Well, how do you know how kidnappers act?
I'm just trying to get us out of here, and I can't get us out of here until I have some clue of why the fuck we're in here.
I don't know. What if we can't make sense of it?
What? Well, we have to.
Sometimes things just don't make sense. What then? We're just stuck in a backwater jail cell for the rest of our lives?
This isn't forever, Max. You can't just hold us here forever.
He didn't seem too convinced of that.
You gotta stay positive. You can't think like that.
Why not? Might as well just accept it, right?
No, fuck that. Think about the rest of the summer, Max. And school? I mean, I've been dreaming about becoming a vet since I was 5 years old. I'm not gonna let this fleabag fuckface stop me. We're gonna get out of here. I'm gonna study to be a vet, and you're... gonna,
What? I'm gonna what?
I saw the letter, Max.
What are you talking about?
The rejection letter for college. I found it in your bag.
You were poking around in my stuff?
I can't believe you didn't tell me.
I was embarrassed.
Wait, Your grades were good and you wrote a great essay?
Yeah, apparently not good enough.
Fuck! You've been making plans, Max. What the fuck?
I don't know. What do you want me to say?
I'm sorry, Max. This really sucks.
Hey, it's not the worst thing to happen this summer. I'm sorry. I shouldn't have kept it from you.
You know you can talk to me about anything, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I do.
Okay, let's just focus on getting out of here for now.
Great. Sign me up.
We need to go over it from the beginning.
Like from when we left home?
Like from when we ran into the cop.
So after we ran into the... whatever we ran into?
Yeah. Actually, yeah, that's when shit started getting weird.
The dude acted super weird when we said we almost hit an animal, you remember that? It was like he already knew or something.
Yeah. Yeah, that was really sketchy.
What if he's not even a real cop?
Well, he's gotta be dirty, but... I mean, I think he's a real cop. We're in a police station.
I mean, yeah, but there's like... nobody else around.
Yeah, that is concerning.
Especially the whole Hackett thing. Let's just go with the idea that they're both in on it.
Okay.
So we're supposed to meet Chris Hackett at the camp, and instead, there's nobody there, and we get attacked by something, and then the cop shows up.
That part's all fuzzy for me. Like, I remember the steps and a smell like wet fur and a dog collar with the name Ian on it.
Ian?
Ian.
I don't think it was a dog that attacked us. Whatever it was big. Like, person-sized big.
Yeah, it really did a number on you. Like, I'm surprised you're not more messed up. Like I vividly remember the thing's teeth ripping into you.
What is messed up about that is... Laura, I don't have a scratch on me.
What?
Hey, okay, so weird question. Do you remember... before we got lost?
You got lost?
Well, yeah, but before that, I was all like, whoa, look at the moon. It's so big, so cool to see a full moon in the middle of the woods, and you were all like, yeah, no shit, Max, it happens once a month.
Yeah, so?
Right, so, you know, full moon.
Yeah.
What if,
Okay, no, stop.
I'm just saying, you know, maybe there's a slight chance it was a werewolf.
Are you out of your
goddamn mind? Werewolves? Seriously? What the fuck? What's so funny?
I said literally the exact same thing.
Okay. Do you got anything better? I mean, like, zombies, aliens, time-hopping Draculas?
Ryan, right?
Yeah?
You want answers? I've got answers. Interrupt me again, you're on your own.
Whatever.
Would it really be so crazy? With all the shit that we've been seeing with Nick? With the thing on the roof? Okay, it would really start to explain a lot of stuff.
Dylan.
I'm just trying to keep an open mind, okay? This is like your ghost stories. How is this so different from your ghost stories?
Those are just campfire stories. Like, there has to be a rational explanation for everything, for all of this.
Okay, you were not talking so rational when you separated my hand from the rest of my body.
You told me to.
And if it's bite with which you're faced, cleave limb from torso with great haste.
What?
You did the right thing.
See? She's got a whole poem about it.
There's more to all this than you think. Just let me finish, and you can decide for yourself if you believe me or not. I don't care. But but I think you should hear all of it. The next few weeks were long. The cop kept us fed and let us take showers, but aside from that, we barely saw him. Max and I, we talked a lot. As much as we could about what happened that night. It was like trading conspiracy theories. We talked about the cop, the camp, the accident, the woods, the thing in the basement, what happened to Max. We just kept going over it all again and again, and nothing was making sense. All we knew is that we needed to get out of there. I can't take this anymore.
It's not that bad. They're probably in the same crap at camp.
No, I can't take being in here anymore.
Oh. Yeah, well, that part's pretty tough.
We've got to do something. We've got to get out of here. We need a plan.
We keep saying that, but it's been weeks, so, you know, let me know if you have one.
That's really not very helpful, Max.
You are forgetting something.
What?
Just the ETBT... tiny detail that I may or may not be a fucking werewolf, Laura.
Keep it down.
So what? What can we do, really? We run off into the sunset only to be stopped when I turn into a nasty-ass monster and kill you and eat you, and then I run off alone into the sunset with little bits of you stuck in my teeth?
Okay, stop. Just one problem at a time. All right, we don't even know if that's what's really going on, and we won't until we get the hell out of here.
Okay. Well, it seems to me that we only have two real options. We can play nice and try to get this guy on our side.
What, so he'll let us go?
Or we try to catch him off guard and make our escape.
Okay, so let's say we get on his good side. What then? Brunch and mimosas every Sunday till he sees the error of his ways?
Yeah, I was being rhetorical. The dude doesn't have a good side to get on. I mean, he don't even talk to us half the time.
I don't know. I think we could crack him.
Laura, I think he's just biding his time until he can figure out a way to get rid of us. Permanently.
I think we should try. I mean, if he was gonna kill us, we'd be dead by now.
So what's he waiting for?
Look, we just... if this doesn't work, we try to escape. Deal?
Yeah. Deal. So... all right, how are we supposed to get this guy to like us if he won't even talk to us?
I don't know. I mean, he's gotta have a weak spot, like something we can use. It's not like we don't have time to figure it out.
Yeah. Okay. Hey! T-Money! Can I call you T-Money?
Why? You can call me Officer Hackett.
Hackett? Like as in Hackett's quarry?
What's it to you?
Just interested is all. Feel like we hardly know you.
Well, let's keep it that way, okay?
Oh, come on, T-Money. Lighten up, man. No reason we can't be buds, right?
I can think of seven.
You're right. We've been just awful, and we really want to make it up to you.
Oh. I see what you're doing. Well, it's not gonna work. You think we're just gonna be besties, and I'm gonna let you walk right out of here. Not gonna happen.
Asshole!
Max! We know what's going on! We know Max is a werewolf! Full moon's in a few days, right? What then?
No, ma'am. You don't know the half of it. I said,
Take your fucking clothes off!
Fuck off!
Get back!
Max, what's going on? Get the fuck away from him!
Come here.
Get off of me!
Shut up. Have a seat.
Stop!
Quit squirming. Said you want to be a vet, right? Call us an internship.
Let me go!
You're not gonna believe it until you see it for yourself.
Just fucking ask next time then, dude. Jeez.
Don't get too close. Mm-hmm. Just wrapping things up here. Down to 20. Over.
What's gonna happen?
Well, I'll tell you. It's not gonna be pretty. But don't worry. I'll be back at dawn.
You're really gonna leave me here?
You'll be fine. Just don't get too close.
Don't worry, Max. I'm here.
Yeah. Yeah, right.
Are you all right?
I don't know. I just don't feel so good.
What do you need? What can I do to help?
Oh, it's just hot. Are you hot?
Well, I'm kind of stuck next to this big-ass pipe, so I'm not exactly cool.
Just stay back, okay? You shouldn't be this close.
There's not a lot I can do about that right now. Max? Max? Tell me what's going on? So much for depth perception. Let's see what that bastard cop's hiding. What's he hiding? What are you hiding, Travis? Anne Radcliffe and Edward Benson. Wonder who they are. Hello? Not so much a hint as a slap in the face. Huh. Mama's boy. 56. That means he was born in 1965. Whoever was wearing this can't be doing too well. This must be what he used to knock me out. I can hide this in my cell. July 7th.
Hikers at all, but ghost hunters who went in search of answers and fell victim to the mercy of the Hag of Hackett's Quarry, never to be seen again.
Like us, except for the fell victim to the mercy of the blah 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 part.
We're more like ghost investigators.
Spectre sleuths?
Sure.
So, what happened next?
Well, according to reports from the local paper, the Northkill Gazette, some hay bales caught fire during the opening night, and that spread pretty quickly. Before they knew it, the whole place was up in smoke, including the show's leading lady and her alleged baby.
You want to tell me what happened?
I could ask you the same thing.
Why didn't you run?
I won't leave Max.
This doesn't mean I trust you.
I don't care.
I just want to help him.
Turn around, hands against the wall.
Seriously?
I am too tired to argue.
But... Ugh. Me too. Happy?
Brew some coffee.
What's this?
An education. Watch. Nice job cleaning up. The eye, I mean.
Harder than they make out in the textbooks. Especially when nobody's helping you.
You're the doctor.
Animal doctor. And no, I'm not. And I probably never will be. Stuck in here forever.
You know, just 'cause you know, doesn't mean you know. You know?
What?
I'm not. This isn't what it seems to be.
You're gonna have to be more specific.
You and Max are in just as much trouble as I am. My family? We didn't mean to hurt anybody. We're just trying to survive like everybody else. Do you understand?
Not really.
We're gonna end this thing once and for all.
We?
Yeah.
So, how is your family involved?
My family is down at the bottom of a well.
What?
Family is the most important thing in the world. But if your whole family, you know, like every last one of them decided to jump down the bottom of a well and they're all just hanging on the end of a rope, how can one person be expected to pull them all back out? You can't. So you pull on that rope and you're just gonna fall right down to the bottom of the well with the rest of them. And what's the point of that?
Right, so you're the one at the top of the well with the rope and...
Yes. I thought that was obvious.
Yeah, okay, yeah, I got it.
Just forget it. Let's see how smart you really are.
What is this?
Information.
Well, what does it mean?
Read it.
When full the moon above shines first, the beast internal shall outward burst. One by one leads lambs to slaughter. It stalks your breath, but shuns clear water. And should you yourself be cursed,
armed with silver and the first. When moon is full before its wane, rend the beast that cursed you slain. No longer shall you face your blight or fear the dread of full moon's light.
Yeah. Keep reading.
And if it's a bite with which you're faced, cleave limb from torso with great haste. Perchance you'll save your cursed soul before infection takes its toll.
Starting to get the picture.
It's not a lot to go on. And frankly, it's shit. Why did they have to make it rhyme?
I don't know. But it's all we have to go on.
Kill the werewolf that bit you and you'll be cured. It has to be silver. Has to be full moon. Seems pretty straightforward to me.
If you can kill the werewolf, and that's a big if.
I just want to cure Max.
It's not as straightforward as you think.
So wait, if Max got me in the eye, doesn't that mean I'm infected now too?
No. Scratches don't do it. Only bites.
Are you sure about that?
Pretty sure.
So what's the plan?
Well, that's where I'm hoping you'll come in.
Me?
Yeah. 'Cause your studies.
I haven't even started.
Well, you're the best option I got. I've been hunting this damn white wolf under the full moon so long I start to think it doesn't exist, you know? Maybe it doesn't matter, because maybe there's another way. Whatever you believe, there's got to be some science. And you do science. Look. Take some time to think about all this. I'll be back in the morning. Seen enough?
I don't think I'd believe a word he just said if I hadn't seen that.
I believe him.
You can't tell me you really trust that guy now.
I didn't say that. I said I believe him about the werewolf stuff, not the science bit. I don't know what he wants.
He's a dirty lying kidnapping cop, Laura. We should be careful of anything that fucker says.
Well, fuck him. He's had his chance to fix this. We're getting out of here and we're gonna fix it on our own.
Hey, Laura?
Yeah?
I saw what happened. What I did to your eye?
Yeah.
Is it bad?
Yeah, it's pretty bad.
I'm so sorry.
It wasn't you. I know it wasn't you.
I know. But it was.
We're gonna fix you, Max. Promise. I promise.
He said, let me in there.
Chris! I know they're in there.
Who? the counselors that didn't show up.
How'd you find out?
Bobby told me.
Said you scrapped an abandoned car. A while back, I worked out the rest.
Shit.
Why?
Why'd you think, Chris?
Jesus, Travis. You're still here? That's fucked up.
Fucking bit one of them, Chris. What was I supposed to do?
What was that?
Nothing. You're sleeping. But I've been a whole lot nicer if I haven't shot
you. You shot me.
I'm telling Mom.
Thank your lucky stars it wasn't silver.
What's your plan? Can't keep him here forever.
I am handling it.
Maybe if you'd done your job, they wouldn't have been at the camp that night. You ever think of that?
If I'd have done my job, you'd all be in prison. You ever think of that?
That was all Bobby and Caleb.
Are those hikers? That fucking journalist?
Damn it, Travis. What are we gonna do now?
Whatever happened to, we're all in this together. Shh, man. Let's go to my office. We shouldn't talk here.
Max! Max!
What is it?
Travis was just in the hall talking, the cop.
So?
With Chris Hackett.
Was he here to let us out?
No. He's the werewolf, Max. Chris Hackett is the one that bit you down on the storm shelter.
Holy shit, that's... Who would have guessed?
I mean, I guess... Thinking about it, I could have...
And yet you didn't.
It all makes sense. That's why Chris's car was at the lodge that night. Travis was protecting him. That's why he followed us, and that's why he didn't kill the werewolf in the storm shelter, because it was his fucking brother. God, it's so obvious.
If Chris was the one that bit me, then...
Yeah, then that's our cure. That's how we fix you.
Jesus, Laura, are we thinking the same thing?
Tomorrow, we're getting out of here. I'm gonna get Travis's gun and kill Chris Hackett.
Hey! Hey! Help her! Laura needs help! Laura? Laura, are you okay?
God damn it. What the hell's going on?
Laura!
Starting to think you were really sick.
Well, maybe I should consider acting as my major.
I wouldn't go that far.
We should go before he wakes up.
We should grab our stuff.
We need silver ammo. He must have some around here.
What is it?
I thought I heard someone.
Something's here.
No, I still can.
This way.
It's coming from behind that door. There's nobody in here. What the fuck?
He makes them.
What is it?
Shotgun shells. He loads them with silver. That's where he was last month, hunting. Well, I guess I won't be needing this anymore.
Hey, I just realized something. We're free.
Hell yeah, we are. That's 2 months we'll never get back, but for now, we're one step closer to going home.
And when is that?
Tonight. Going to Hackett's quarry, and we're killing Chris Hackett. And I made my way here, to camp. Left Max at the island. Seemed like the best place for him, surrounded by water and all. That's it. That's the story. Don't all jump in at the same time.
Wait. The island? Like our island? Like the one in the lake?
Yeah, why?
'Cause Jacob, he went back there looking for Emma, and he hasn't come back yet. Neither of them has. Oh, shit.
Well, if they were there, they're not there now.
What's that supposed to mean?
Don't make me spell it out for you. I've just come back from there, and there's one werewolf and no people.
Oh, fuck.
All I know is I have to do this. I have to kill Chris Hackett before it's too late. After you saw me at the pool, after I shot Chris, I went back to the island expecting Max to be back to normal. But Max? Max! Max? Hello?
Ah!
So the werewolf I killed can't have been Chris.
That wasn't a werewolf. It was Haley Hackett, Chris's daughter.
Whatever I shot, that was no girl. Unless, I guess, it turned back after I shot it, when I went to the island.
Wait, so how come Max didn't kill you then?
He tried. I got away. I need to end this. We don't have much time.
Smell good, don't I? Go on, take a bite. Come on. Dumb fucking animal.
You want? Cause my dad's got money. Like lots of it. Are you? I mean, not really, but you could get some, probably. Please, just let me go, please. I'm so sorry.
Oh, Jesus Christ!
That's two, Bobby.
Hey! Hey! Hey, where are you going? Hey!